Meghan Trainor. It's a privilege for us to be joined by one of the most celebrated artists in music today.
I have a question is, how do you maintain such a high standard of song quality time and time again?
Is that a compliment? Thank you.
Okay, hi. Front row here.
I love you, you're awesome.
I love you, you're awesome, thank you.
Okay, what are some things that have helped you stay grounded with the amount of fame you've received?
It's weird, I don't feel like I'm famous. That's so funny.
You are.
Thank you.
Trust I think.
My family. And my family. And they believed in me when no one did.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your songwriting process?
Oh, it's different every time. Sometimes it'll wake me up in my sleep. Sometimes I'll be in the shower. A lot of great songs are written in the shower.
Yep.
Yup. Or in the car. I wrote Dear Future Husband on the car ride all the way to my session that takes. I was like, I got it. So, doesn't matter how you do it, just matters how it gets done.
Hi.
Hi.
After you got your publishing deal, what were some of the crucial steps that you took that got you where you are today?
Oh, I took every session. Every songwriting session. I started collaborating and my publisher would put me in sessions and I wrote with strangers every single day. Like you meet people and they're like, oh, you're really good. You should write with this person who writes with Rita Ora, you know? And I climbed up that way. And eventually I met a lot of great people. That's how I actually met Paul Pontius at L.A. Reid, at L.A. Reid's office and at Epic Records.
Do you want to collaborate with me?
Okay.
But you can answer the first
one. You're a songwriter, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I saw your picture in the papers they gave me. All right, guys.
Really?
Yeah, they gave me paper, like all your little headshots. It's so cute.
Did I look handsome?
So cute. Okay, so you looked great.
Hi.
Hi.
So I love your catchy melodies.
Oh, thank you.
And I was wondering if there's any specific way that you go about refining your melodies after you to keep it interesting and balanced and things like that.
There's only 12 notes, right? So I sometimes when I was younger, when I would write songs, I'd be like, okay, I did one in C, and then I'd close my eyes and go, we're doing it in A today, you know? And I would just switch it up on myself. But nowadays, I don't think about I know I like hearing F sharp major, but I know little tricks for myself for melody. I know if you stay around the root, the main note, if you just swim around that, it's easier for someone to sing along to it. Like, because you know I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass. You know how I'm just swimming around it? And I had to learn from doing it on accident. I was like, why were these songs so catchy? But my favorite thing about writing songs is having a catchy melody that just destroys people's dreams. Like, they're like, oh, I can't sleep anymore because I'm just singing your songs. I'm like, That's my favorite part about this. But Treat Myself was, it was my first time ever experiencing physical anxiety. I didn't know anxiety could make you feel like you want to throw up or like feel physically ill. I remember I had to cancel this big event, cancel a lot of shows because I had to do my second vocal surgery. And it rattled me. So I wrote about that this time around with Treat Myself, and I when I came out of that, because of my family and a lot of doctors and therapy, I realized like, oh, life is awesome. Life is awesome. And you just gotta remind yourself how awesome life can be and how positive energy really helps you become a happier person. I got over it though, it was good.
Did I not tell you she was cool?